today I'm going to take you on a virtual walk through a little bog we have here on site. What is a bog? Well, really, it's a type of wetland that accumulates dead plant material without decomposing it. Our bog at NCROC is relatively small, but there are larger bogs throughout northern Minnesota, the United States, Canada, and indeed around the world. The bogs here in Minnesota began forming at the end of the last glacial period, when the glaciers melted and formed shallow lakes of various sizes with no outlets. Over time, grasses and plants at the edge of the lake would die and fall in and settle at the bottom. With no outlet, the partially decaying plant material builds up and eventually fills in the lake. This process created the bog you see here today. The way bogs form over time is what gives them their unique environment. When you're standing on a bog and notice its wet, spongy, bouncy surface, that's because you're not standing on soil or dirt, you're standing on several feet of partially decayed plant matter, or peat. There's very little oxygen in the decaying plant matter, and the pH is more acidic than you'd find in the surrounding forest soils. So what values do bogs provide? They're home to a unique plant community. Only certain plants can do well in a bog's wet, low fertility, low pH environment. Sphagnum moss gives it that pillowy look. Pitcher plants are carnivorous. They attract and drown insects and then dissolve them as a source of nutrients. Small cranberry is a creeping vine that produces a small, red, tart berry. And snowberry is a creeping vine similar to small cranberry, but with a white berry that tastes of wintergreen. If you see any of these four plants, it's a good indication that you're on or very near a bog. Bogs also hold runoff water. Whenever it rains, they trap that water in the sphagnum and it stabilizes the water table. It also acts as a natural fire break in the forest. Bogs can act as a natural carbon sink. During very hot weather, they can act as a cooler place for animals to escape the heat. Much larger bogs can be farmed for peat, which eventually shows up as potting soil. And that's all I have. Thank you for coming on this virtual tour, and I hope you get a chance to visit our bog at the North Central Research and Outreach Center in person very soon.